In today's Take a Day, I want to talk about the Los Angeles Clippers and how they made a good investment in regards to Terrence Mann. Now, before we get into that, though, please like, subscribe, also hit the notification bell just so you can get the newest and the bonus content first. We put out content every day so you won't miss any content here. Now, let's go ahead and jump right into this. We've all seen Terrence Mann play in the last playoffs. We all saw what he did. We all were impressed. We all were impressed with everything that, you know, he did in regards to just coming in off the bench, giving energy, coming in off the bench, playing defense, not being scared of the moment, having a fearless attitude, and playing a big role in helping them win a series that they were down 0-2 in, which was the Utah Jazz. And, you know, him coming off the bench, putting in that 39 points that game really saved Paul George's career slash legacy, because if they lose that game, which I think was game six, and they take a game seven back to Utah, I'm pretty sure, who knows, but I'm pretty sure they might actually lose that one. And if they lose that, then Paul George's legacy goes down the drain a little bit more to me, only because Kawhi was out and, you know, you had a team where who was playing really good, who living off resiliency, and a team that you can actually help get past a team like Utah. You're good enough to beat a team like Utah in a seven-game series by yourself. And that game six, Paul George wasn't playing to his capability, I thought. And here come Terrence Mann. Terrence Mann comes up with 39 big points, saved the day. And then going forward in the playoffs, you know, he played really good, played solid minutes, you know, came in, was a spark, just like he was the regular season of last year as well. And just like the Clippers think he will be this season, this is the reason why they actually took the chance and the opportunity to go ahead and sign Terrence Mann to this contract that he has, because they really definitely feel like he's worth it, and they definitely feel like they're making a good investment towards a player who's going to be a future star for the team, and a player right now coming off the bench that can really supply them with the goods, basically. A player that's coming off the bench that can be looked into the six-man role, winning a six-man of the year award, possibly, type role, you know, going forward for the Clippers as well. So, you know, that's like having another Lou Williams, even though he's not as good as new Lou Williams is offensively, but he is a decent offensive weapon, and he is really, really good on defense. And, you know, like I said, him playing with that fearlessness makes him a formidable player, and it makes him a valuable player to a team. And he brings that spark, that energy, and he makes big plays at times. You got to give it to him. So, you know, definitely a good investment, I think, for the Clippers in regards to looking at a player that they have in him who can definitely help this team win a championship, be a part of a championship. And like I said, if he's coming off the bench with Brandon Boston and a few other guys and Luke Kennard and those guys, I mean, they really might have the best bench in the NBA when it's all said and done, when everybody's healthy, because you got Terrence Mann coming off the bench. You'll probably have Luke Kennard. You'll probably have Brandon Boston, you know, and then you'll have Zubac, because, you know, Serge eventually be in the starting lineup if he can stay healthy, you know, and that would be really, really good to have. And maybe even Harry Giles coming off the bench as well. So that would be like probably one of the deepest benches in the NBA once they get Kawhi Leonard back. So, you know, having somebody like Terrence Mann lead the charge off the bench, being the leader off the bench that he can become, you know, signing him and giving him hope that, you know, you want him to be there as a Clipper, and you want to show support towards what he's already done by rewarding him with a contract that you've given him, which is a $22 million contract, is that's really good. That's a really good move by the Clippers, I think, you know, because they see potential in the player, and they're actually rewarding him for what he's done and for what they think he can do going forward. And that's definitely a good sign for, you know, both sides. You know, in regards to Terrence Mann, that's a good sign for him, because he's looking at it like, okay, this team kind of believes in me. This team believes in what I can do. You know, this team, really likes me and cherishes, you know, what, you know, my attitude and the mentality I bring to this locker room. And the organization could look at it from a standpoint of, we really like this kid, and he brings a lot of energy and toughness on defense, which is the reason why why we felt the need that we can get rid of a Patrick Beverley and a Rondo, because he could be both of them players combined into one, possibly, without the attitude, you know. So, but as far as his defense, he can definitely play that. He's definitely stronger than what people think, and he definitely could help the Clippers, you know, win a lot of games going in the regular season and some playoff games as well, from what we saw last year in the postseason. So, you know, from the Clippers standpoint and from Terrence Mann's standpoint, it's definitely a good situation, and it definitely makes sense. You know, I'm definitely glad for Terrence Mann, and it's good to see, you know, a player like him, you know, start from nowhere and get an opportunity and run with it. And now he's signed, you know, with the biggest contract he's ever had, and, you know, probably definitely more to come in the future. So in my estimation, you know, he's going to have to come out, you know, and ball out this year, or at least go out there and, you know, show the effort, like you want to be, you know, not only a part of this team, but you're really a focal point of the team as well, and continue that from this past postseason going into this season, going into the next postseason, the next one. So, I mean, I definitely think he has that mentality, and I definitely hope he goes out there and plays the best that he can, because I think the contract is going to have, you know, it definitely has him excited. And, I'm pretty sure the Clippers organization is excited for him. So, I mean, you know, now when you get more money, comes with more responsibility. So I definitely hope Terrence Mann is up for the challenge, which I believe that he is. He's definitely a warrior, you know, type guy from what I see. And, you know, he's definitely ready to, you know, make his mark or make a move, you know, in the NBA, you know. And I think that he's going to be one of them players that comes off the bench for the Clippers that a lot of people in Clipper Nation are going to value, you know, for a while going forward. So, you know, hopefully he can come in there and do his job, and maybe he might be in the starting lineup in the season now. You know, who knows with Ty Lue, he switches up his lineups, you know, all those type things. But whether he's in the starting lineup or not, I expect big things out of him this year, and I know he expect big things out of himself. So, you know, I definitely can't wait to see how that all pans out and how the you know, how his season goes as well. But hey, that's my take on everything. Leave any comments in the comment section as always, and we'll discuss it and we'll engage. You know, how you feel about Terrence Mann's contract? Too big, too little, or is it the right investment? As I said, leave any comments as always, and hey, Khaliis out.